Blue catfish are typically found where the water is brackish. Brackish means fresh and saltwater mix. In the spring, in March and April, when the water is still cool, they tend to be on the edges of the channels coming up out of the deeper water. As the water warms, they will eventually get up to the flatter areas where it's shallow. So typically we like to try to find the edges of the channel. Tools we have are sonar, which is the depth finder, and also have side scan. So we make our leaders about 2 feet long or so, maybe a little longer, and we snell the hook. Using circle hooks, it allows for an easy hook ratio. That allows the fish to swallow the hook every time.
Pretty simple snell, always come to the front. Make it a circle right there under my fingers, pinch it in real tight. Now just wrap 5 times.
We put the weight about 2 feet ahead of the bait, so if he picks it up, the line will slide up the weight, and he won't feel the tension, he won't spit it out or drop it when he knows something's up. We do use a barrel swivel. That's how we attach the braided line to the leader, is with a barrel swivel, and the weight is ahead of the barrel swivel, so it stops it. And then you have a 2 foot leader attached to your circle hook. We snell them. It's almost foolproof. We typically like to lock the spool up and let the tension of the fish come, and just, that's how the circle hook works. When he swims away with it and everything comes tight, that's how the circle just kind of rolls and comes right in their corner of the mouth. Fresh bait is better for all the fish.
We use menhaden.
So you take a whole fish and cut them up into chunks. It's a very oily fish. It's pretty much the main forage in the bay, in this part of the bay, in the rivers. Chumming, it definitely helps attract them. Any kind of extra added oil or scent you could put in the water, kind of, they'll be curious. They kind of work your way to your baits. We take groups fishing. When we catch all our fish at the end of the day, we clean them and bag them for them, and they take them home.
Ta-da.
That's the one you'll lose.
There's a blue catfish.
Okay, so basically what you would do is you just take your knife and you kind of run it from that top fin there, diagonal, to miss all the rib cage and the wasted meat. You just fillet down, make a cut down to the spine, and you just turn and take the fillet right off the spine there, just file the bones down, and once you get the fillet, then we'll turn and take the skin right off the fillet, so we have a nice pretty fillet of white meat. We found that bleeding them, just clipping the gills and letting them bleed out is a lot better. The meat is a lot cleaner. And then from there, you just take it and clean it all up, and we'll cut it into small chunks. Well, we encourage people to eat them because they're great eating. They're excellent table fare. It's a great time. It's a lot of action. Typically, it's light tackle. Like I said, it's very good eating. There's no limit. So you can keep as many as you want. We'll clean them up for you, and you'll take them home to enjoy for all your family and friends.